name is Saheed Adekunle Muraina, Department of Accounting,
Ahmadu Bello,
Zaria. Being a paper presented at the 2020 Science Tech Central Conference Thailand, based on the research topic titled Determinants of Defined Benefit Pension Performance in Nigeria. Introduction. The examinations of pension fund asset and liabilities has gained more attention across countries of the world, especially developing economies such as Nigeria. This is as a result of the fact that there is a persistent and tremendous growth of aging population worldwide, and imaginable looming financial crisis of pension scheme is a matter of great concern to direct and indirect stakeholders in the pension industry globally. Nigerian pension scheme started in 1951 through the adoption of a British pension model, which colonized Nigeria. They actually instituted a pension for British officials, which actually retrospectively started in 1946. It was only applicable to British officials transferred to Nigeria to work for the government of Nigeria, but it's not applicable to Nigerians working in the country. In line with the Section 42 of 2014 Pension Reform Act, the mandate of Pension Transfer Arrangement Directorate was to take over the functions of the Parastatal Pension Office, Civil Service Pension Office, Police Pension Office, as well as the Civil Defense, Customs, Immigration Office. The aim of PITAG was to clear the backlogs of the government pension liabilities under the benefit pension scheme in Nigeria. Now, to what extent are determinants of pension fund performance affected pension industry, especially PTAD in Nigeria? Statement of problem. The essence of this current empirical research is that the impact of contributory pension scheme has been overblocked, overemphasized, and overstressed. Therefore, there is hardly any empirical research on defined benefit pension scheme in Nigeria, especially after the 2014 Pension Reform Act. It can also be seen that the visual empirical studies, such as the January 2014, use of 2016, among others, they were all based on contributing pension scheme. This therefore attempts this study therefore makes attempt to fix some gaps in literature by examining the determinants of defined benefit pension scheme in Nigeria, so as to identify their impact on the PITAG's performance. Research questions. This study sought to provide an answer to the following research questions. Does number of pensioners on payroll significantly affect the defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria? Does amount of pension paid significantly affect the defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria? Does GDP significantly affect pension fund performance in Nigeria? Objectives of the study. The main objective of this study is to examine the impact of defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Specifically, the study attempts to achieve the following objectives: to examine the effect of number of pensioners on payroll on defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria, the effect of amount of pension paid on defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria, the effect of GDP on defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Hypothesis of the study. In line with the objectives mentioned above, the following hypotheses have been formulated in number. Number one, number of pensioners on payroll has no significant effect on the benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Amount of pension paid has no significant effect on the benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Gross domestic product, GDP, has no significant effect on the benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Scope of the study. This study examined the determinants of defined benefit fund performance in Nigeria using a case study of Pension Transfer Arrangement Directorate, PITAG, for the period of January 2017 to December 2019. Using independent variables such as number of pensioners on payroll, amount of pension paid, and GDP, which as an independent variable proceed by Treasury funded pension fund performance in Nigeria. So these are the scopes of the study. Then significance of the study. We have significance related to this study. The outcome of this study is expected to benefit pension regulators, pension unions, ministries, departments, and agencies of government in Nigeria, such as Federal Ministry of Finance, Office of the Accountant General of the Federation, Central Bank of Nigeria, among others, because this will essentially help them to identify the factors affecting pension fund performance in Nigeria. Literature review. In this session, previous literatures relating to the determinants of pension fund performance in Nigeria and other countries were reviewed. We look at international studies as well as domestic studies such as the Japanese 2014, then Kai 2016, Oxfam 2013, among others. Theoretical meaning. This theory or this study actually used certain theories such as productivity theory of pensions as well as agency theory. Methodology. In this section, the site design, which is number one in this section, specifically we use a correlational research design, which has to do with statistical relations between two or more variables. The population of distance, we use all the four personal departments in BTAD as a population of the study and also the sample, because all the data were used fully. Then sources of data, we use secondary sources of data. Then the test of data analysis, we use multiple regression techniques, specifically easy robust regression for data analysis and interpretation. Variable measurement and definition. Here, we have process for the variables used in this study, as well as measurements and sources. Model specification. In this study, we look at the impact of determinants of defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Specifically, the model used is designed in order to establish the relationship between dependent and independent variables. Then robustness test. Here we use robustness tests such as a test for heteroscedasticity as well as test for multicollinearity. Data presentation analysis. Here we look at the data, analyze it using certain economic variables and techniques. We carried out descriptive statistics and empirical statistics. We also carried out tests of robustness, such as the test for heteroscedasticity as well as the test for multicollinearity. Then descriptive statistics. Here we look at the minimum, maximum, standard deviation, skewness, and kurtosis, as can be seen. Descriptive statistics, we look at the variables which are three in number. For independent variables, then we have a non-dependent variable. Then we have one critical observation. We have mean standard deviation, minimum, maximum, skewness, and kurtosis. For the skewness and kurtosis, it has actually shown that the range of a plus and minus 3 has shown that the data used in this study are normally distributed. Robustness test. We carried out robustness tests based on the need for it in this study. This includes tests for multicollinearity as well as tests for heteroscedasticity. Then, multicollinearity specifically, we use a variance inflation factor and also tolerance value. Then the coefficient for the tolerance value has actually shown that the range is from 0.1 to 0.9, which shows that there is no any issue of multicollinearity, according to which are at 1995. Then, presentation and discussion of regression results. Here we look at the data and we carried out the following tests, such as tests for OLA, that is ordinary least square. Then we also did tests for GLA, that is generalized least square, specifically fixed effect and random effect. But the Hausmann test in this study actually specified that this effect is the most appropriate model for this study. We move further to actually carry out modified Bayes test for groupwise heteroscedasticity in this effect, which actually specified that there is a presence of heteroscedasticity in the unit of this study, significant at 1%. In view of this, we used PC robust regression to take care of the issue of heteroscedasticity in the fixed effect model. Therefore, the interpretation analysis of the data of this study was carried out using PC robust regression, which has actually shown that the variables are significant at 1%, for number of pensions of bureau, 1% for amount of pensions paid, and also 5% for GDP respectively. The number of pensions of bureau and also amount of pension paid show positive and significant relationship between the variables and the dependent behavior, which is a treasury funded pension contribution for allocation, which means that as the number of pensioners are increasing, then the need for treasury funded pension and contribution also increase. The negative relationship between the GDP and also treasury funded pension contribution shows that as the pension is being paid, it is majorly used by pensioners for consumption purpose rather than investment purpose. Then here we also have a test of a hypothesis. The test of hypothesis shows that we need to reject null hypothesis and accept alternative hypothesis that the variables used in this study are significant at 5%, 1%, and 1% respectively. Implication of findings. The findings obtained from this study have implications for defined energy pension for pensioners in Nigeria as well as pension industry generally. Then conclusions. After careful analysis of the study results and also discussion, as well as review of relevant literatures, the study concludes that the internal pension variables, such as number of pensioners of bureau, as well as amount of pension paid, have significant effect on pension fund performance in Nigeria. The pension reform of 2004, as well as pension reform of 2014, as amended in Nigeria, who explain the rationale behind the relative improvement in defined benefit pension fund performance in Nigeria. Limitations of this study. The study covers only structured benefit pension scheme managed by PTAD, that is Pension Transfer Arrangement Directorate in Nigeria, and non-contributory pension administrators in Nigeria, because the pension fund performance of contributory pension scheme may not be influenced by the same factors being examined in this study. Recommendations. Based on the study findings and the conclusion above, the following recommendations are provided to enhance the performance of defined benefit pension scheme in Nigeria. Number one, on how to make defined benefit pension plan a long-term undertaking that can clear the backlogs of all pension liabilities under defined benefit pension scheme in Nigeria. Then there is need to establish defined benefit pension fund protection. Otherwise, defined benefit pension protection fund (DBPPF). In order to make sure that there is a portion of consolidated revenue fund (TRF) reserved to fund the defined benefit pension protection fund, so that there will be a reserve for a rainy day as far as clearing the backlog of your pension liabilities is concerned. Then another recommendation provided in this study is that the directory should establish an alliance with commercial banks used by pensioners for their proof of assistance virtual verification from time to time. This will alleviate their plight in the course of their movement from one place to another just to get physically verified. Suggestions for further research. This study is believed to have paved the way for further research in the following areas. The study only used three variables, whether there are other factors that can affect pension performance, especially in Nigeria. It is therefore suggested that the future researchers who might be interested in this area of study should expand the scope to include other factors excluded in this study. Thank you for listening. Bye.